Hi there, my name is Ruth and I'm going to draw a daffodil for you today. You might be able to have a go at this at home. I'm going to look at it, very important to look at it, side at a nice angle, and I'm going to take a line for a walk. So, first of all, I'm going to do that lovely little frilly trumpet. And more than anything, I'm looking at the daffodil, not at what I'm drawing. I'm going to look at it a bit, not massively. I can see its little stamens, and that part's the trumpet, and I can see how they all curve in like that, the centre. And now I'm going to take another line for a walk with the petals. Daffodils like this anyway, traditional daffodils, always have six petals, so that makes life easy. So I'm going to have a go at each of these petals. Ooh. And you'll all be used to whiteboards, and I'm very used to whiteboards because I used to teach in school, so I drew a lot on whiteboards, and I drew a lot of daffodils on whiteboards. And even though they look quite complicated, they're actually really easy. If you compare them with a rose, it's quite complicated and confusing to follow all the lines. A daffodil is a lovely thing to draw because it sort of has a beginning, a middle, and an end. Right, so that's one, it's not too bad. I've done better, I've definitely done worse. And when you're doing the stalk, if you can, using a pen and a piece of paper, run your hand down in one nice even stroke. First one's easy, that's your first stalk. And the next one, you're trying to do a parallel line because obviously the stalks aren't like this. Now, many children do this, and I bet you don't, but this is what many children do. Stalks like that. And I don't know where that comes from, but I've seen it many times, so I know it happens. So instead of that, you just follow it like a train track all the way down, as parallel as you can get it. Not perfect, but it'll do. So that's a tip for the stalks. Daffodils don't grow on trees. They grow on stalks. Okay, I'm just going to rub some of this out and start again in a minute. Hi there, back to the second daffodil. This is a very nice daffodil, a kind of pale lemon colour. It's not the bright yellow that the traditional daffodil is, but it's still a nice colour. And the back of a daffodil is gorgeous too. I don't know if anyone ever draws the back of a daffodil as much. Well, they certainly don't as much as the front. Anyway, one of the tips about drawing a daffodil or anything is keep it still. Don't keep changing the angle, because if you keep changing the angle, it's not going to work, is it? Because it's all going to change. So look at this beautiful daffodil. Just trying to keep it still as I can. And I'm going to first of all start with the trumpet. Start with some of these lines. That's the kind of beginning of the trumpet. That lovely frilly bit. And some of you will do this absolutely perfectly because children are always very good at doing frilly bits. There we go. That's the beginning. Maybe a bit messy. Of course, you could do this with a pencil first. If you do it with a pencil first, then you can go over it with black ink, can't you? And you can rub out any mistakes. So I would advise that, really. You've got a nice steady hand to go over what you've already done. Okay, so let's do that edge that we can see. And then these lines start going like this round. There's some beautiful colours and shadows in this daffodil, which just with line I can't do. I could do it with paint, or try it anyway, but just with lines I just kind of have to look at the outline of what I'm seeing. That's the beginning of the daffodil. I always do it this bit first, I think I always do anyway. Well, it makes sense to do that. And so there's six petals, so the lemon colour as it concentrates, oh, she's going to kick off now. The lemon colour as it concentrates, when you look at where the petals meet the trumpet of the daffodil, are particularly lovely. So there we go. Trying not to make it up. That was my dog Keeper, who says it's tea time. Keeper's one of her names, she's a few different names, but one of them is Studio Dog. That's got a bit wrong. Thanks a lot, Keeper, it's your fault. But anyway, don't be frightened to rub out. When I was at school, my art teacher said, you never need to rub out, your first line is right. But I haven't found that to be true. Maybe he was an absolute superstar drawer. Okay, so that's not bad. Let's get the stalk in. Stalk makes it look really alive. So here's a stalk. Doing what I said, parallel line, following the line. And then put some more of these lovely lines in, lovely petal lines. And the edge of the petals kind of sometimes fold over a little bit. And that's a fun thing to draw because it's so easy. Because you just go like that and it looks like the petals are kind of moving. They nearly are. And then, oh.
Looks good.
Right, another little trick when you're drawing daffodils, which is really a trick. I can't pretend I'm absolutely looking at my daffodils when I do this, but it works. Right, they kind of twist and turn. I mean, this one, face that bit faces me there, that bit faces the back, the front, the back again, I think. Yeah, the back again. Okay, so I'm going to go sort of like this. So there I have the back, the front, and the back, the front, the back again. And that really works for daffodil leaves. So I'm going to do a bit more of that. Just love the way they bend round like that. Of course, I know I'm making it look easy. I've done it so often, so many times. So just practice, and just that's all it is. Practice makes perfect in every aspect of life. So, and then I might put some more daffodils in there. I was going to do a whole picture, a whole painting. At this point, I'd start thinking about the composition. I don't know if you know what that is exactly. Some of you obviously will, if anybody older is watching it, but if you're younger, you might not know exactly what composition is. And composition is how you arrange things. Like at home, when you arrange your furniture in a room, you arrange it so it looks nice. And that's just what it is with composition. That's what it really means, how you put things on a piece of paper or a painting or three-dimensional, two-dimensional. And I haven't thought much about composition with this because I've just been drawing the daffodils as examples. So. If I was going to think about composition at this point, because you might not straight away, I'd start thinking, oh, well, if I put a daffodil, say, up there with the writing, that would look quite nice. And if I put a daffodil down there, because you want the eye to flow around whatever it is you're drawing. And I'll put more leaves, and obviously they're just kind of sitting there, but I could try and make them look like they're growing instead, so I could go... kind of like bring them down. Never worry about going off the edge of the paper, that never matters. Don't try and fit things into paper. Don't worry if your stalks suddenly get a bit fatter towards the base, because they do. So just do that. Oh, that's not a great line, never mind. This is why rubbing out is a wonderful thing. I'll try again. It's nice when you can rest your hand. So, I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just put in a few more daffodils, and you probably don't want to just be watching me doing all this forever and ever. You want to get on and start doing it yourself. So I might come back in a minute when I've done about six more daffodils and then just show you a bit of what it looks like when it's finished. Okay? These daffodils that haven't opened are lovely to draw. And another thing that's lovely to draw with daffodils is the lovely papery bit at the back. Of course, the great pleasure really of drawing and painting daffodils is painting them because of the gorgeous colours. In watercolour is particularly nice. Anyway, I'm going to have a go at this little daffodil going like that. Right, so this is what I've ended up with. I have thought about composition, of course. As you can see, it's like a picture now, not just one or two daffodils. And I've put in a few stars and a few hearts because I'm thinking about Easter and maybe Easter eggs and decoration and making it quite pretty and making it up a bit. But I haven't made up the drawings of the daffodils, tried not to anyway. And I hope that you children who are looking at this will feel a little bit inspired to have a go at this yourselves. But what is really, really important and will give you beautiful, beautiful art is to look at what you are drawing. Because if I just tried to make it up, if I thought, oh, what does a daffodil look like, and made it up, it just wouldn't be half as good. It's looking, 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 looking. And then you can make it up a bit after, can't you? I've put in some hearts, and I'd love to colour all this in now and to turn the background like a lovely sky blue and the yellow of the daffodils and perhaps some pink hearts and maybe some gold stars, and then wrap a lovely big chocolate Easter egg with it. Okay, guys, all you kids, good luck with your work. Bye-bye.